Hi guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. My name's Yudana. If you're new here, please consider sticking around, subscribe, and hit the notification icon so you know when I upload. If you're already subscribed, just check that you're still subscribed, because, I don't know, for some people, they just unsubscribed. It's not because they don't like me, I promise. They just, no, people have been saying to me that they've been unsubscribed. So, just check. If you're one of my return subscribers, hi guys, how are you doing? You know what? I'm trying to be upbeat, as I usually am, but it's hard because today marks the 20th anniversary of 9/11. Well, it does today at least. I don't know when you're watching it, but this is when I'm recording it. And sad times. It is sad times. I can't believe it's 20 years. Last year, I reacted to Alan Jackson, Where Were You When the World Stopped Turning, and I can't believe the response that I got in the comment section from that video. It was insane. It was actually, it was really touching, but incredibly heartbreaking to read the comments. I remember saying in that video, you know, do you remember where you were when you found out, when you heard it, when you saw it? And of course, everyone remembers that. And all the different stories in the comment section on that, you know, were just a lot. A lot. But you know what? It needs to be a lot, because it's real. And I'm sick of people shying away from what's real. And it is real. And here we are. Well, here you guys are as well. Especially, I mean, here I am over in the UK. And this wasn't my country. This is the US. I felt it deeply, and I still feel it deeply for you. It'll never be okay. It'll never be okay. But we'll never forget. So I'm going to react today to, I guess as a, not a tribute, but just to honour all of the people that lost their lives and the servicemen and women that were there. Everybody that is still touched by it, moved by it, affected by it. I just don't like the idea of brushing it aside and saying, hey, you know what? So anyway, shall we get into it? So this year I have decided to react to Daryl Worley. I think it's Worley. I've never reacted to him before. This is one that was recommended. I believe it's country as well. And as you guys know, I've really gotten into country, especially since I started the channel. So it's Daryl Worley, Have You Forgotten? Oh, wow, I'm choking up already. I haven't heard it, I haven't seen it. But I do know when we edit this, we're going to try and put our own spin on it and actually take some of the comments from the last video, some of people's real comments, real stories, the truth, and kind of add it in if we can, We're going to try and do that, because there's just so many. If you haven't seen that video, go take a look at that one as well. I will link the this video in the description below, and the last one too. So, first time hearing, I hope I'm saying this right. I don't know why I'm struggling to say it. Daryl Worley, Have You Forgotten? I'm going to try and hold my ish together. Bear with me through the pausing on this, guys. I don't want it to get blocked, so I'm gonna pause.
I hear people say we don't need this war, but I say there's some things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? We didn't get to keep them by backing down.
I really like the song in itself. I like the sound. I like his voice. But yeah, I'm more in this for the lyrics, I'm gonna be straight, so it's not letting me down so far. Let me know in the comment section if you already know it. This was actually recorded in, what was it, in 2009. Go back a little bit.
We didn't get to keep them by backing down.
It's true.
They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell. And you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? It took all the footage off my TV, said it's too disturbing for you and me. It'll just breed anger, that's what the experts say. If it was up to me, I'd show it every day.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, I would too. I'm sorry if that's not sorry actually, that's an unpopular opinion. I would show it. It's I couldn't agree more. I couldn't agree more. Why the hell should you forget? Why the hell should you not? I mean, of course, it's everybody's choice. It's your choice. It's your opinion. If you don't want to see it, if you don't want to watch it, that's understandable. It's your choice. It's horrific. But don't let the generations forget.
What the experts say, if it was up to me, I'd show it every day.
This is written from the heart.
Some say this country's just out looking for a fight. After 9/11, man, I'd have to say that's right. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell.
You know what else? Sorry, yeah, I'm sitting here as a Brit here, sitting back, looking in, and I'll talk more about this at the end. But the one thing that just struck me then about seeing that piece of footage and hearing the lyrics there about saying, "Oh, it's breeding hate, this, that, and the other." You know what though? I have never seen America more together ever than I did then. America was so together. Everybody. Because they had that one thing, and then the whole world, majority, the whole world. We weren't there with you, but damn, it felt like it. It certainly did. It certainly did for me. I mean, I can't imagine. But you know what? They say it breeds hate, but does it though? Because I've never seen the country more together. I've never seen America come together like that. Everybody. So what about that? That's just my two cents on it.
Have you forgotten? I've been there with the soldiers who've gone away to war, and you can bet that they remember just what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten? Oh, have you forgotten? Have you forgotten?
Edit this piece out. Just let me get my shit together. Okay, just edit this bit out. Just do like a clean cut. I feel like I almost don't have a right to get to like to cry because it wasn't my country and I wasn't there, but fuck. It hits hard. Okay. Okay. No. Okay. Ah, it's one of those ones where I don't really know how to come back now. That was moving. That was fucking sad. I mean, it was powerful. It was sad. But it was also necessary. The footage is hard to watch. But like he says in the lyrics, and everybody's entitled to their opinion, meaning I'm also entitled to mine. Why must we not talk about it or show it? That's like, damn, I mean, that's it's like saying to anybody when you lost someone, or you can't talk about it anymore because it makes other people feel uncomfortable. Fuck them. Tough. Talk about them. I'm not doing very well with this one. I'm sorry, guys. I just can't, I don't know, I feel a lot of ways. I can't imagine. Thank you to everybody that commented on the last video that I did last year. I wish I could have responded to them all. I read them all. Every time a comment, still now, and especially now because it's the anniversary, they're coming in today and they were coming in yesterday. And I read them and I sit there and I cry because you guys are my subscribers and these are your families and this is so personal. And, you know, how... I do read them, and thank you for sharing your very personal stories with me. I said in the last video, I remember where I was. I was in Germany at the time. I was working on as a civilian on a British army base in Germany. I know, get your head around that. So I was a civilian for the British Army in Germany, and it came on TV screens and like the whole base just went into like shut down, and I just remember thinking, what the, you know, it was just nuts. No one could quite figure out what we were looking at, what was going on, why the base was shutting down. And then I remember seeing the Pentagon and I was like, we kind of realized, yeah, it was crazy. And then, of course, a lot of people have flown out. Sleepy Joe. I can't get into that. Okay. I can't get into that. Right, guys, I'm sorry I don't have much more to say. Hopefully you understand my reaction. It's a whole bunch of different emotions, but believe me, what you're feeling, I'm probably feeling it too with you. Perhaps not to the same degree because I wasn't there. But I'm so sorry to all of you that were and still are in your heads a lot of the time, because that shit's real. Right. On that somber note, but necessary note, let's not forget them. Let's remember to pay respects to all of them today with the moment of silence. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Smash the thumbs up on this because it lets the algorithm know. And fingers crossed you guys get to see it and it didn't get blocked. And until next time, I've got plenty more videos coming, all different kinds, different genres. I know I always say that, but I do. But this was important today. So I hope you're doing okay today. And come say hi to me in the comments. Come let me know your story. I hope you're okay. Sending lots and lots of love from the UK today to America. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.